Good morning, good afternoon to you all, whether you are here with us at the Art of VivaTech in Paris or remotely connected. I am very pleased to have this meeting, this stage with Laureline. I am Jean-Christophe Labar, in charge of innovation, partnership and strategy for Mobilize. Mobilize, which is the brand which goes beyond automotive. We are very pleased to pitch about Mobility 360. Mobility 360, it's four major mobility players, RATP Group, Mobilize, Uber, and BlaBlaCar, working together hand in hand to make sure that we can have an impact on mobility services to provide simpler, greener, more affordable and accessible mobility offers. Today, the situation is quite difficult when you want to move from point A to point B. It's complex, too many apps on your smartphone, silos, fragmented offers, a lack of dialogue between public authorities and operators. And that's the essence of Mobility 360 with Uber, BlaBlaCar, Mobilize, and RATP Group. Yes, this is the essence. It means that we want to have an impact on those points. Four major impacts. The impact on public spaces. How do we make sure that we can contribute to less congested and more welcoming cities? The impact on the user experience. How do we make sure that we can provide seamless, more accessible and affordable mobility offers? Mobility offers for all our users. We also want to have an impact on the carbon footprint. How do we do less give cities less congested solutions? And at the end of those four pillars, we also want to make it simple. Simple for our users and also simple for the cities. That's the essence of Mobility 360. By doing so, it means that we want to have a collaborative approach. This is what we are doing within Mobility 360 and by producing, having the right level of conversations with the cities and all the operators. Laureline, you are the head of Uber in France. Floor to yours.
Thank you very much, Jean-Christophe, and hi, everyone. I'm extremely pleased to be here. So I do really thank you for your invitation today. And so let's talk about a bit this Mobility 360 initiative. So this initiative is a unique one, and I can tell you that even in the world of Uber, internally, when I look across the world, it's a very innovative approach that we are taking here, and I'm very proud of that. And to me, it's very meaningful in terms of the direction and the vision that we have also at Uber. So basically, what is Mobility 360? Like Jean-Christophe talked a bit about that. And to me, it's a gathering of state-owned and private companies who have very different histories. Think of Uber and RATP and Mobilize, a very recent company as well. We have very different players with very different backgrounds, but we do share a common vision. And that vision is very important to me because, like, if we have to summarize very quickly, Jean-Christophe talked about that. It's about green and shared mobility in a world where tomorrow, I hope, will diminish, if not abandon, the usage of individual cars to the benefit of a shared and more sustainable mobility. That's really the vision that is gathering us in this coalition, I would say. Then, like, why is it important to Uber? Because by essence, this vision is really deeply embedded into what we're doing, trying to do on a daily basis at Uber. And when you think of that, we've been like trying to push that vision for many years now. Like the principle of PHV drivers of ride-hailing business, by essence, is about not using anymore an individual car, and instead of that, share a car with a driver to use less space, to have less congestion on the road. So that was the essence from the beginning of the business model of Uber. But if you go beyond that and look at what we've been doing, for instance, in 2016 in France, We've been launching an option that is called Uber Pool. Maybe some of you know that. It's an option where you can order a trip and share it with other passengers. So it requires the tech behind, of course, because this means that we need to match riders who go the same direction and who can share a trip, basically. And that's a way to make the trip even more efficient from a green standpoint as well, from a sustainability standpoint. So shared mobility is one. Also, we've been launching the green option on our platform a few years ago as well. So what is green is, like, if you open the Uber app and try to order a trip, you will have the green option. And if we call a green car, you will get either an EV, electric vehicle, or an hybrid car. And that's it. So that's also to try to encourage and grow a more sustainable mobility. And the third piece that we've been doing that is extremely important to us and dear to my heart as well, is we've been also doing a very strong push towards electric vehicles, and we take the very strong commitment to ban every diesel cars from the platform by 2024 and to have 50% of electric vehicles by 2025. And when you think of that in terms of what it means for the drivers, the change it requires from them, it's a massive bet that we are making. And for that, we can't do that alone. Like the transformation toward electric fleets is not something that we can do alone at Uber. And we needed to build and to work with the ecosystem. And that was also one of the reasons why we were so happy to join Mobility 360. Now, back to Mobility 360, what do we expect from that, and why are we joining Mobility 360? The number one reason is that beyond the vision, it's great to have a vision, but then what's next? How does it come concrete, right? We're trying to make our own vision concrete. How do we materialize that? The number one thing that we're envisaging is definitely there are many things we can do, and one option that we're working on, for instance, is like the transit trips, and the first mile and last mile transportation that could complement the existing MOF offers in terms of mobility. Quite often, the reason why you need your personal car is because you can't really go from point A precisely to point B precisely without having your own car. And the objective is that we join forces and have like this multimodal approach across all of us to propose more fluid and more efficient journeys to the riders, to our customers. That's one. Another axis that is also very important to me is that, like, if you think of a driver on Uber, they are driving 250 kilometers a day. That can't be achieved without having a very solid infrastructure in terms of EV charging, right? They need to recharge their electric vehicles. And for that, we all need that. That's also the direction that is taking Mobilize. We need to also help the ecosystem develop this charging ecosystem, basically network. So that's another axis that is very important to us. And beyond those very concrete actions that are like kind of obvious in the directions we are taking, we're also trying to push for a bit more forward-looking things and test innovations that will really like experiments that will where users will really try to not take their own cars anymore for a given period of time. And when you think of that, probably all of you has already taken a scooter or an electric scooter or an electric bike, you know, from Jump or whatever. Maybe you've also like been taking some Uber, but have you been spending 1 month without taking your car at all? Probably not, right? So that's the kind of things that we're trying to push and the kind of tests we want to conduct together. And one other thing that is extremely important when you talk about all of that is that for that, not only do we need to gather within this coalition, but also we do need to work hand in hand with public authorities, right? We can't achieve that alone. And this is why this coalition is so important, because I hope it will help public authorities to, you know, contact us more easily, right? We're a very scattered ecosystem with tons of innovative players, tons of startups, a lot of established players as well. And creating this coalition is a way for them to simplify. You are saying simple, simple. That's more simple to go to us also and to discuss with at least the first bunch of players across the ecosystem. And for us, it's also a way to engage with them in a more coherent, more consistent, and more aligned manner. So that's very important. And so concretely, what are we doing? The first thing we've been doing with Mobilize is work on like a way to help the transition to electric vehicles for drivers. The number one thing we've done is have like an agreement with Mobilize by which the drivers on the Uber platform have access to discounts on electric vehicles, so -18% on the price of a Zoe, -21% on the price of a Nissan Leaf, which is like critical, because if you think in terms of the obstacles today for a driver to go for electric mobility, you have two main ones. Number one is the access and the price of the electric vehicle. And the second is the charging infrastructure, as I was saying earlier. So that is absolutely critical, and we're so happy that we could do that agreement with Mobilize. But that's not enough. We have already done that, so what's next? There are tons of other stuff that we could do together in terms of battery recycling, but also, I hope, one day, in terms of like future vehicles that will come on the market. Like today, the market is, like, and those electric vehicles were until recently not necessarily thought for the usage of PHEV drivers, for instance. So we really hope that it's just the beginning of a very continued story in the long term. And beyond that, as I was saying, I hope that we'll materialize quite soon an experiment, I hope also with public authorities, on transit options where we could use the technology of Uber in terms of dispatching and matching algorithmically the demand from various users, together with the high-capacity vehicles from Mobilize, to offer new services that do not really exist in France yet. So that's it. Thanks a lot for your attention, and I give you the floor back, Jean-Christophe.
Thanks a lot, Laurelina. I think this is the best way ever to describe what Mobility 360 is. And you see that the key word is collaboration, collaboration, and collaboration, not just for the sake of collaborating, making sure that we could have an impact on those mobility services to join everything together to make it simpler, greener, and to everyone. Thanks a lot, Laureline.
Thank you very much.